This is an example of getting in close with a resident. And let me explain by what I mean, getting in close with a resident. Everybody in this room has his or her own social space. As I'm talking to Mary here, me as a workshop instructor, Mary as a workshop participant, I feel very comfortable talking to Mary at this distance. I feel that if I get like this close, maybe there's a lot of noise in the room, maybe I can't quite hear what she's saying. I feel I get about here and it's like I sort of want to pull back. Try it sometime. You can back a person all the way around a room by getting into their space. I've never traveled to Europe, but I understand people that do say that foreigners are pushy. And I've heard somebody say it's just that their social space is a lot smaller and that they're used to getting really close to people and talking right in somebody's face. With a resident that's total care, as I talk to the resident, if I stand way back here at the foot of the bed, I'm not going to get through to that person. When I worked with Evelyn earlier in doing the scent therapy, I got right up in her ear. Do you notice how close I got to her? I tried to get in her line of vision to get her eye contact. I'm trying to get her to smell the vanilla and mint and trying to react that way. I always have to have a talk with myself, like I had to do when I worked with Evelyn and with the person I did the inner tube tire stretching with up here, because I get really close into these people and I say to myself, gosh, this is uncomfortable. I don't like being this close to this other person. But then I tell myself, this is not a social situation. I'm really trying to get through and to reach into this person. So you may have to do the same thing. That's an example of an approach to talk right in the person's ear about 4 or 5 inches from their face or their ear. That's another approach to get in their eye contact. If they're looking this way or they're looking over this way, put your face right where their eyes are looking. It's another example of an approach with a bedridden resident. Now, with this particular resident, what is he doing? Right. This is a stage 4 withdrawn resident that did not talk, that would kind of moan and maybe thrash around a little bit. And when this resident, I just happened to have my camera there that day, reached up and grabbed the activity director's hand, she went, because it startled her, because she was so used to this person simply not responding. Look at the next slide. He would not let her hand go. You have to ask yourself, did he really want her to stay, or did he see a face, hear a voice, and with Alzheimer's disease where nerve endings, the messages aren't getting through because there's a lack of an enzyme in the brain that the message doesn't get from one nerve ending to the other, has a part of a thought, and then that's gone, holds on to her hand, and then simply forgets that he's holding on to her hand. The responsibility of working with a bedridden resident is you don't know. Let me go back to Evelyn. I did some scent therapy earlier with Evelyn. I had her smell some vanilla and mint. If Evelyn were a bedridden resident, does she only thrash around and moan violently when she's smelling vanilla and mint? She may be thinking, oh no, here's the vanilla and mint lady again, but I can't tell her to get that stuff out of my face. You have a responsibility to this type of resident because they can't tell you. In activities, and about 80% of you in this room are activity directors, take some time to observe your bedridden residents. Talk to the nurse aide. See how they normally interact. And then try some of these things so you'll have some basic information about the resident. This is a communication board. It's a more elaborate communication board than what I showed you. And the pictures are simply posted on the Jerry chair tray.